So hi everyone, another filler video. I do apologize, but this one's sort of important. I have encapsulated a lot of thoughts of mine around five lessons that I've learned in the past 8 years of software development and 5 years after graduating. The prime motivation behind this video is that I met my batchmate yesterday and we were basically discussing where everyone is today. This is 2018 IIT Roorkee Computer Science batch. And we realized a lot of things that felt extremely unintuitive to us back then are so obvious now, and like everyone's happy in their lives. And once you've like made money for a few years or been in a job, a lot of sort of hassles go away, anxiety goes away, and you start to see life a different way. So I wanted to share five such very concrete lessons slash things that don't seem very obvious when you're in college or when you're trying to get into tech and you're like very anxious to get your first job. What are these unintuitive things that if you zoom out a little and look at them and try to inculcate them, basically understand what I'm saying, you will reach times in your life where you have to choose one path amongst the two, and then hopefully this framework lets you choose that path and make a better decision. Let's get right into the video. The first one is called Zero Sum Games and Abundance Mindset. So there's a very famous story that a friend once told me. It goes something like this. Once there was a crab seller and he had 3 buckets of crabs. There were Russian crabs, Chinese crabs and Indian crabs. The Russian crabs and the Chinese crabs buckets were covered. They had lids, but the Indian crabs bucket was open. Someone asked, hey, why is the Indian crabs bucket open? And he said, well, don't worry about it. These are Indian crabs. If one tries to go out, the other pulls them down. This is a very real statement, a very sort of influential person told me, and I think it does apply very well to Indians, is we have a very zero-sum mindset, which means from a very concrete example, if our friend gets into Google for a 15 lakh per annum offer, we feel like our probability has suddenly gotten low. And we internally hope, let's say his offer gets revoked, or like more importantly, if he wouldn't have gotten in, maybe I had a higher probability of getting in. That's when you feel life is zero sum. You feel there are limited opportunities of value, and if someone takes some value, your value has been reduced. The other side of this is abundance mindset, where if your friend makes it to a job in Google, you tell him, hey, great that you've made it. I want to do it too. Just take like 10% of my salary. Teach me how you got in and get me in. And then later on, take 10% of my salary. I don't care. That's called abundance mindset, where you don't really care of paying him, where you want to create more value in the world, become another person who gets into Google versus hoping that the other person sort of gets out. This also relates very well to the course that I'm launching. There were basically no sort of courses for full stack development with like a lot of focus on open source contributions. I brought one which was paid, and I tried. My goal was to create value in the world. The second point is always be the dumbest person in the room. I'll give another analogy here. Let's say you had 2 choices. One, all of your friends made 50,000 rupees a month and you made 1 lakh rupees a month, or all of your friends made 5 lakh rupees a month but you made 3 lakh rupees a month. Which one would you choose? Believe it or not, a lot of people would choose the first option because they want to be the smartest person amongst their group. They always want to be the smartest person in the room, which is not the right way to go about it, because then you're not growing. You're helping other people grow, which is great. But if you're the dumbest person in the room, you basically have a lot to learn and a lot to gain through passive mentorship, through just talking to these people and like reaching their level. Don't bring jealousy into the picture here. Don't feel like, oh fuck, I'm the one who's earning the least. Well, you're also the one who's the dumbest right now. And if you're in this room, globally on a meta level, you're learning a lot of things and you're slowly approaching 5 lakh rupees a month if you're with these people, versus if you're making 1 lakh and everyone is making 50,000, they're approaching you. Another example here is, let's say you get into a big company, let's say you get into a bank, and you know that your company is sort of fairly complacent, your team, you don't have to do much there. Versus you get the offer to join a startup where it is like extremely intense work and like extremely haphazard, and then the tech stack changes every day. Choose the startup, because learning matters a lot. You don't want to be complacent early in your life. You want to be in an environment where you're always on your toes. That way you're like the dumbest person in the room. That way you grow a lot and learn a lot from the people around you. Point number three. Third point is, if you feel like you want to get into tech and you're basically deciding between tech and brick and mortar, go for tech, even if you can make more money in brick and mortar. I'll give a few examples. I had a decent rank in IIT JEE, and like the very obvious choice for me after college was just join an IIT JEE tuition and make a lot of money. If I would have joined an IIT JEE tuition, I would have made like 60 lakh per annum right out of college, and Goldman paid me like half of that. But I know I did not want to join a brick and mortar system, or like I wanted to remain in tech. I always wanted to build more things and get into this field that's ever changing so quickly. Now that like AI is coming into the picture and disrupting everything, I am in the epicenter of this, and I can build products, make more money, do a bunch of things if I stay here. If you're a technologist, don't spend your time worrying about, oh, this guy made like XYZ through his shop, or if I was an ITC teacher, I would have made more. It always feels very overwhelming, and like a lot of times your business friends are making a lot of money, but trust me, you'll get there. I'll give an example here. I met like the biggest educator in India who has like a very big education channel, and like he has a complete ed tech and sort of makes a lot of money. And I asked him, he basically left a FANG job to do this. I asked him, how's it going? He's like, it's good. I know I've made a big business. I make like a few CR every year, but there is a ceiling, there are taxes, and what am I doing? Like, up until last year, I was making much less, but I could see myself make a lot more thanks to tech. Here in this ed tech, my growth has been stopped. I'm teaching everyone, so I'm not really learning. Two, I'm like drained very heavily because like my job now is not writing code. My job on a day-to-day basis is teaching people. So it's like extremely draining. And three, what I make, if you remove GST and taxes from it, if I just did a remote job and got my money in Dubai, did not pay taxes, would have been the same amount. So he's stuck in this existential question of, why did I become a teacher again? If it was to build a business, I wish I would have just stayed in tech, built businesses, or like just been an employee for that matter, and then would have probably made more money or similar money. But two, more importantly, I would have grown. Like, I don't know what will happen in the next 5 years when I'm still teaching DSA to everyone. And like DS is not even used. Maybe AI is used. And since my job now is to teach people, I don't really have the time to learn AI. And neither am I with the people who will teach me. But like, there's zero mentorship now. I'm the one who's providing mentorship. So basically, I'm fairly lost. So that gave me like high conviction in my belief of I would never want to make money through an edtech. And always stay in technology, because you can easily eventually make more money if you're in tech, because things get disrupted very quickly. Today, in the next 5 years, you don't know what jobs will go away, but it's very obvious that brick and mortar goes away first before tech. And hence, if I had to take a bet, I would stay in technology. Even if I could make 30-40% more in a brick and mortar, I would not sacrifice, one, building a better future through technology, and two, more importantly, generally my learning, what kind of people I'm spending my time with, and what am I doing on a day-to-day basis for that. Cool? Brick and mortar versus tech. If you want to be a technologist, cut the noise. Don't worry about your friend making a lot of money selling mattresses or whatever brick and mortar. I'm sure it's a great business, but you will get there. Don't let anxiety hit you. If you want to be a technologist, you will make money sooner than later. Let's move to the fourth point. The fourth point is the Phoenix analogy. This is something I've felt very closely, and it's very common in tech. So there's this mythological bird called the Phoenix, and the story is that it burns itself every few years. It burns itself down to ashes and reincarnates from it and then builds a better future. I think this is very relevant in tech. I'll tell you when this happened for me. My first job, when I was basically like an unemployed college student, and my first job ever in tech was like 30 lakh per annum, which is pretty good, right after college. It's the first time you sort of burn yourself to the ground and you get your first job offer. And this is something that more or less everyone feels, because well, before tech existed, it was very hard for a 22-year-old to get an offer like this. As life goes by, there are other stages in life, in tech especially, where you feel like you've reincarnated, you've like burned down to the ashes, and your life has sort of restarted, or like there's a new phase in your life. My second such phase was when I started consulting, and I realized, oh fuck, like you can make 100K. And like, it's not even bad. I'm not scamming anyone. Like, if people in the US feel like 100K is very cheap for a software developer, I feel like 100K is a lot of money for me. So win-win. Why was I killing myself in Bangalore with an on-site job for 30 lakh per annum? So this was the second time I sort of reincarnated and new phase of my life began. Finally, recently, I sort of had a lot of conviction in low latency systems, or this is something that I want to learn. And I realized I want to move away from this and build something bigger. And that's sort of, I think, the next phase of my life that's coming, where I'm again getting a similar feeling where it feels like a new phase of my life is starting and something new that will come from here. And I would look back and feel like, oh, fuck, I used to work for money. I was an employee. That sounds weird. So in tech, I think these stages happen very quickly, where you sort of go through a transitional phase of not just salary, but like generally what you're doing on a day-to-day basis. And I think tech is the only field where this happens so quickly. So if you feel like your life is extremely stagnated at the moment and you're stuck in the same job for a while, if you hustle correctly, I think you'll get such moments in life where you'd feel like, okay, this is a new life, it feels, and like, why was I doing what I was doing before this? So wait for those moments. And if you're not getting those moments, probably hustle a little bit more, you'll get there. Last point, tech is extremely anxiety inducing for everyone. So I feel like there are a few prodigies who are like really good at tech from the beginning, but for most other people, tech is very anxiety inducing. When the first time you get into tech, you see like everyone getting great jobs. You sort of get in that circle of oh fuck, why is everyone making so much money and why am I stuck in, I don't know, a 5 lakh per annum job? This happens and it's very normal. Feeling competitive is also very normal if your friends are getting here and there. And it's very hard to see like positive some outcomes there. It's all very easy to be like, oh fuck, this guy got a job, I'm not getting a job now. But trust me, if you stay in tech, eventually you'll realize, like, I know friends now who say no to higher offers just because they want peace. Like, they'll say no to a 40 lakh offer, they'll be happy with their 30 lakh per annum offer because they want peace, they're happy in their job. And tech doesn't necessarily mean you have to become like the best techie out there. Even if you're a normal person who's not interested in tech, it's a decent outcome for a full-time job, and then you can decide what you want to do next. A lot of my friends primarily are singers or comedians, but they have full-time jobs in tech just because like it's a decent way to make like 1 lakh rupees a month, and that's what they're happy with. And they don't really get stuck in anxiety because, well, their friend got here or a friend got there. Once you've been in the industry and made like a few lakh rupees, you'll realize that life matters much more than, oh my god, my friend is making 5 lakh rupees more than me. Again, these are things that are very easy for me to say now. I've dealt with all of this in college, even after college, but you guys are better than me and I want you guys to be better than me, which is why I'm sharing this. A lot of this you will only learn with time only. I can tell you this and you can probably relate to it later on in life. You might not be able to inculcate it just yet, but if you ever get a choice between these two, for example, zero sum and positive sum games, go for the positive sum games. The world is positive sum. There has been value created over the years. Tech did not exist as an industry it does today. AI was nothing 5 years ago and suddenly is taking over the world. So there is a lot of positive value that's created in the world. Value is never really taken from one person and given to the next one. Keep your mind open. And if you want to get into tech, I have a very strong personal bias. I never wanted to get into tech. I wanted to be a filmmaker. But I got here and realized that this is changing the world. And this might sound very salesy, ki, haan, he wants everyone to become a developer. You do you. I couldn't care. But it's a decent 1 lakh per month offer. If you don't want to get into tech, it's like the decent way to make money remotely or otherwise. You really want to get into tech, it's the best thing that happened to me. And tech does not necessarily mean you're always restricted. Even like AI as a field, if you're in tech, if you're a software developer, if you're a full stack developer, it's easy for you to break into it. So there's always like decent paths to get there, versus if you've always been in brick and mortar, you can't really break into AI directly. So you always have a path to future looking technologies, which I have a strong feeling will change the world, both AI and Web3. And you have a path to get there. Be like at the epicenter of it if you're in tech. So that was my suggestion. 5 life lessons. Take it as you will. I'm again repeating a lot of these things. You will only learn with time. But I wanted to put it out there. And hopefully a few of you got some value from it. From next video onwards, we're back to coding and making open source contributions. This was the last meta video for a while. I hope to see all of you in the next one. Bye.